I take you to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for sicker, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part, 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 till death do us part.
If you haven't guessed by now, yes, this is my entry for the Knicks Face Awards 2016, and I'm so excited. This side's going to be the bride side, and that side's going to be the skeleton. So let's go ahead and get started. I am using just an eye pencil just to divide my face so I know exactly where to put the product. Just here using foundation to just stipple this all over my face. This shouldn't take as long to do because we're only doing half of my face. Because this is the Knicks Face Awards, I won't be actually talking about any of the products themselves due to the rules, but I will tell you exactly what I'm doing and what kind of product it is. Next, I'm just going in and filling in my brows, or brow singular, I guess. The skeleton side doesn't have an eyebrow. So that's what I'm doing here. And then next I'm going to go in just with some concealer and just conceal those under eye circles. This is the bride side, so we're trying to make her look as beautiful as possible. So I'm just highlighting the areas that I normally would. And then I'm just going in with a damp beauty blender and blending out that concealer under the eyes and everywhere else that I have put it. Next, I'm going to set all the areas that I conceal just with a yellow brightening powder so it's nice and bright underneath the eyes. And then next, I'm going to go in and bronze up the face just with a large fluffy brush, just really making your face look a little bit more vibrant, not as pale. So now that we have bronzed some of the face, I'm going to go in and just contour a little bit more on that cheekbone area just to make it really pop and stand out. And then I'm going to go in and place some blush just on the apples of my cheek, just a nice rosy, beautiful pink shade for any bride. Now I'm putting a highlighter. I'm first going to start with a cream highlighter stick and just putting that on the high points of my cheekbone. And this is just going to prep and be a nice base for the highlighter that I'm putting. So I'm just placing that on the high points of my cheek, a little bit above my eye there. Next, we're going to move to the eyes. I am just priming the eyes for the eyeshadows, and this will also help to cancel out any redness that I have on the lid. First, I'm going with the light brown shade, and this is just going to be buffed all in the crease area, and this is going to act as a transition for the other colors that I'll be using. Just inner to outer corner, really buffing in that shade. Now I'm going with a little bit darker of a brown, and I'm focusing this a little bit lower in the crease, and also in the outer V of the eye. So I'm just blending, blending, blending. Now I'm gonna be going in with a lid shade that's a really pop of sparkle, of course, for any bride. I'm actually gonna be going in with another even more sparkly shadow, if that's possible. But I'm just using this as a base, again, going in with no additional product, just a buffing brush, just to blend out the crease area. This is the bright, even brighter glitter shade, so beautiful. And I'm just patting this just on the lid again, and then going back in with a brush with no additional product and just blending it out so it's just smooth in the crease. Now I'm going to be putting on some eyeliner. I will be doing a wing today. So I'm just using some black gel liner and drawing it out just to make that nice cat eye, drawing it back in, filling in the triangle, and creating that nice winged look. Next, me going in and placing on the false lash. Singular lash. I'm just putting on some mascara just to prep the eyes, plapping on that lash and squeezing it just so it's really stuck to my other lashes and on there well. And now you can see the difference. Obviously this side is done and this side is not. Let's go ahead and finish this side. So I'm just going in back with that gel liner and just putting this in the waterline. Nothing too crazy on the bottom lash line. We're just going to put that brown dark shade we used in the crease up top and just blend it out. And that's all we're doing to the bottom lash line. Just going to throw on some mascara and then we're going to move to the rest. Now we have the lipstick. I'm just doing a nice pink bridal color, just lining them and then just filling them in with this liquid lipstick here. Now this is going to be the final look for the top part of the bridal side. Now we're moving to the body. So all of the clothes, everything that I'm drawing today, I like to draw out first just with a white pencil. So that's what I'm doing here. And then I'm gonna go ahead and fill in what I drew. And this is going to be the dress side, so the bridal side. And here I'm just going in with a water activated paint. Again, I can't talk about the actual products themselves, but I will tell you exactly what they are and what kind of product they are. So again, this is a water activated body paint. So I'm just going to be filling it in now. I'm not doing any shading because that's what I'm going to be doing later. So now I'm going to the skeleton side and I'm really just mapping out where everything's going to go. Again, I'm just using that white eyeliner pencil just to map everything out. Once it's mapped, I'm going to go in with that white paint again and just fill in all of the spaces except for a few spots where I know I'm going to be doing black. Most of it's going to be all white though. So that's what I'll let you see me do here, just filling in all the spaces. Now I'm going to be drawing on all the skeleton side. This side is pretty intense, so I did speed it up as I did with the rest of this video, just so you can see exactly where I place it. This is just a rough draft of where the bones are all going to be. The great thing about using an eyeliner pencil ahead of time is that you can just dust it right off if it's not exactly what you want. But I am using a reference picture. I'm trying to make this as anatomically possible, although it is pretty difficult to do, especially when you're doing it on yourself. But as you can see, I drew all of the actual rib cage, the clavicle, the humerus, and then here just putting in the scapula up in the back. Again, this is all just a rough sketch, and then we're going to go ahead and paint it. So here we are starting with the white, and as you can see, I'm just painting all of the bones white, and you may have to go over them a couple times, especially with the white because it can get streaky. So that's what I did. I went over it, let it dry, and by the time I went back, a nice second coat was perfect. Now I'm going in with a gray water activated paint just to fill in the scapula area. The whole dimension of this is going to look as though that's really behind the bones, and later you'll see with the shading how it begins to kind of all come together. Right now I'm really just focusing on placing down all of the actual paints and the shades, and then we're going to be going back and really highlighting and shading everything, and that's when again it really comes together and makes it look a little bit more dimensional. So now I'm just trying to really visually pick out where the scapula would be behind all of these bones. So that's what you see me doing here. Really just filling in any little spaces. There are going to be some black spaces here, but that's all we're going to be doing with the gray. Now I'm just using the black to just fill in all the large places with a larger brush. I try not to do as close to the specific lines as possible because I'm going to be using a smaller brush for those areas. But I do get as close as I can, and then I'll go in and really point out exactly where I want things to go. So as you can see here, I'm just filling in the rest of the black. And again, if you need to go over the shades with more than once, let it dry and then do another shade. As you can see here, the black is looking pretty patchy, but I do go over it again and you'll see it looks a little bit better. So just as we did with the gray shade, I'm going to be going in and filling in all the rest of the areas where there is no gray on that side, because that's going to be all black. So that's what I'm doing here, just filling in every little ounce, and I'll just let you watch me do this here. Now we're going to go ahead and move back to the face, again using the same concept that we did on the body. I'm really just filling in any areas with the black, and then again, no shading or highlighting yet. That'll come soon. Thank you. Now I'm going to go ahead and focus on the teeth. What I'm really trying to make here is such dimension that looks as though the teeth are really going back and settling back into the jaw area. So as you can see, I started out fairly large and I'm getting a little bit smaller and a little bit smaller. It really helps to kind of make it look as though it's not one straight line across. So I'm doing the top and bottom. Then we're gonna move to some shading. So I'm first starting with gray. The only two colors we're gonna be shading with for the skeleton side are actually gray and black. So I'm first going into all the areas and really doing any shading that I want to with the gray. So I'm really focusing on areas where you would naturally have a shadow, like in between the teeth here you'll see, anywhere we can make this as realistic as possible. So I'm really just creating that dimension with the teeth and really just drawing as much of the gums I can. So again, this is just the gray and I'll be going back afterwards and doing more detail with the black right here. All of the places that we put the gray shadow before, we're doing a little bit more depth with some black shadow as well. So as you can see, I'm kind of really creating this sunken in look around the actual eye socket itself. I had already put the gray down and I'm just making a little bit more intense with the black. Now with the black, I'm also drawing some detail cracks throughout the skull. You really can do this however you want. There is no pattern to it whatsoever. Wherever you feel like there should be a crack, girl, you put a crack. Since I did a ton of shading, now I'm gonna go ahead and do some highlighting. So I'm just taking a white cream paint and just highlighting all the areas I feel need some brightness. So anytime there's gonna be a shadow, there's always gonna be a highlight. You know I learned that from Jordan Hans. She's amazing. I'll put her information below. I'm sure you already know who she is. So now I'm just going in and shading the bottom area of the skull. And this is going to put the dark shades anywhere where a natural shadow would be. So for example, there's a rib on top of a rib. I'm trying to put the shadows underneath them so it looks as though they're raised and on top of the other one. So that's what I'm focusing on here, just using the gray eyeshadow just to create some more dimension. I think I've said dimension like 20 times now, but that's what I'm trying to do here is really make it look as realistic as possible, as realistic as a skeleton can be. So first I went over with the gray, now I'm making a little bit more darker shades with black. So now I'm pretty much done shading on the skeleton side, so I'm gonna be going in and doing some more detail work. So anywhere where I feel like the bones really need to stick out a little bit more, I'm just doing some very fine black lines just so you can see them a little bit better and they're not kind of lost in all the shading. Just like we did with the skull above, I'm gonna be highlighting just with some white cream paint, just on the highlights of the where the bones would be and just blending it in. And I believe we're pretty much done with that side. Now we're gonna move back to the dress. We're not doing a ton with here. We wanna keep this super simple. All I'm doing is taking a very light brown shade. I actually think it was a transition shade that we used earlier on the eyes. And I'm really just helping to look as though the dress is kind of coming off of my skin so that it's not actual just paint on my body. And I'm really just darkening up those areas that would really have a natural shadow on top of them. Now to make the dress look like it has some ruffles and some dimension, we're gonna actually be putting some of that brown shade just on the inner and outer corner and then really defining the top of the dress with just a very thin line. And guys, that's pretty much all we're gonna be doing to the dress side. The hair and the veil are gonna pretty much cover it anyways, and the skeleton was the side that I really wanted to focus on. So now I'm just doing some highlighting and we are done with the dress. Since we highlighted and contoured the face so much, I'm doing the same here just with the clavicle area and a little bit on my chest area. I'm just making those shadows and then adding some highlight just again to give them more dimension and just to stand out a little bit more. Now I'm going in with some blood. I like to add this just because it really helps to divide the two sides. This is just some scab blood and all I'm taking is just a small makeup spatula and just placing this along the line down the center, really just making it look however I want, trying not to get it too much out of line. And then here I'm just adding on the beautiful veil and this is the final look, you guys. Let's go ahead and see what it looks like all together. Oh wait, I forgot the contacts. There you go. Okay, guys, so this is my final look. I hope that you liked how it came out. Oh, I love it so, so much. So please make sure that you go and like it. Please subscribe. Please share it. Again, this is my entry for the NYX Face Awards 2016, and I'm so excited to enter. So thank you all so, so much for watching. Bye-bye.